If the world were perfect and we operated on an honor system, we wouldn't have a need for passwords. Everyone would just go to a website, tell them what their username is, and that would be it. There would be no need for any other form of verification. But back here in the real world, websites need a way to confirm that we are who we say that we are. So they ask you for something that hopefully only you know, your password. Of course, another option would be to go with something biometric, something physical about your body, like your fingerprint, for example. But not every website that you're going to go to would have a fingerprint reader. Hi, everybody, and welcome to ControlCase's YouTube channel. Today, we are starting our Cybersecurity Simplified series, and the topic of the very first discussion is going to be one of the fundamentals of cybersecurity, passwords. Yes, passwords can be a frustrating experience, but they really are one of the best tools we have right now to make sure that we are who we say that we are. So we need to make sure that our passwords are strong enough to withstand most attackers. If you've spent any time on the internet, you've probably heard every password tip at this point, but they really are worth repeating. And a question that we need to ask ourselves is, why do those tips work so well? Passwords are unfortunately not perfect. And if someone knows your information, or more accurately, correctly guesses it, they can have insight onto some of your most important decisions, like your banking information, your healthcare information. If they really wanted to do damage, they could even access and delete all of your cloud stored memories. And unlike a safe you might have in the real world, attackers don't need to travel anywhere physical. They can access your information from the comfort of their home. But how do hackers guess your password? The easiest way to do it is to see if your username and password is already online. Many companies fall victim to hacking attacks, and the lists of usernames and passwords get leaked onto sites. The good news is they're usually not going to be leaked in plain text, they'll be encrypted. There are things in math that are easy to do one way, but hard to do the other way. So if I ask you, for example, what is 34 to the fifth power? You could multiply 34 by itself 5 times. But if I asked you, what to the power of what will give you 279,841? It would be a lot harder. The answer, by the way, is 23 to the fourth power. Encryption does that many times, along with another array of one-way operations to take your password and to turn it into something completely different, an untraceable combination of letters and numbers. However, if a website's encryption isn't all that advanced, two users with the same password would end up with the same combination of numbers and letters after encryption. That is why it's recommended not to pick the most common passwords, like 1234, password, I love you, because even if it's leaked and the passwords are encrypted, hackers can see a lot of these passwords are encrypted in the same way. So if they guess the password 1234, everyone with that password, they would have access to their accounts. So if that's the case, why does password length matter if they all end up as a combination of random strings of numbers and letters? Password length is going to matter because of the second way that hackers will try and guess your password, which is just through brute force attempts. If your password doesn't show up on a leaked site that's encrypted with your password information, and people still want into your account, they're going to try and guess every possible password combination, or more accurately, they're going to have a bot try and guess every possible password combination. So AAAA, AAAB, AAAC, and so on and so forth. So let's say your password has 4 characters, each with 26 possible letter options. That's just under 500,000 options for what your password could be, which is gonna seem like a high number until I tell you that there are bots that can guess 1 billion passwords in 1 second. Adding numbers and symbols to our passwords will increase the possible password options by a lot, about 80 million. But by far and away, the best way to increase your possible password options is to increase the length of your password. For every additional character that you add, the number of potential passwords increases exponentially. With numbers, symbols, lowercase letters, uppercase letters, it becomes a potential for 94 characters. So every additional character is increasing your potential passwords by 94-fold. So that means for the average 12-character password, it would take 7.5 million years to crack. It's not all that easy to remember 12 randomly chosen letters, numbers, and characters. So instead of picking a password, what's a lot easier is oftentimes to pick a passphrase. This isn't all that difficult. Pick out a couple of words, it'll end up being a very long password, and then you add in some well-placed numbers, characters, etc., and you'll have a very long password that's very difficult to crack. There are diminishing returns, and most websites won't let you choose a password that's longer than 20 characters. It's also advised that you don't pick something with with words that they can find out about you from other places on the internet. So maybe your pet name or your birthday. But regardless, passphrases are still a really helpful way to make the security of your password much better. Of course, if you keep reusing the same password, that means if a hacker gains access to one account, they can gain access to all of them, which can be a really fast process. They have programs that will automate this for them, so you may not even know that they've gained access. It can be really hard to remember one password, let alone a unique password for every website that you visit. So something that a lot of security experts will recommend is a password manager. Password managers are a great tool. They'll have unique encrypted passwords for each website that you go to. You would just obviously want to keep the password to your password manager very secret. Unfortunately, even with all of these protections and tips, there's still ways that hackers can get your information. And a really common one is actually by you giving it to them. They'll often impersonate official sites and ask you to input information. They could send you a sales email that's seemingly harmless. They could send you a notification that someone is trying to send a file to you. Or ironically, they could even send you an email saying, "Hey, your password has changed." This is why it's really important that you pay attention before you put any private information online. So double check URLs, make sure that there isn't, for example, a capital I in place of a lowercase l. Be careful about links, try to make sure that they're secure before you click on them, and double check with people who contacts maybe who are sending you files. These sort of psychological security attacks could be an entire different video topic, and maybe we'll do that. Comment below if you're interested. But all in all, even being alert and aware that they are out there will go miles to protect you and to protect the privacy of your information. All right, everyone, that is going to wrap up our discussion on passwords. I hope you enjoyed the first episode of Cybersecurity Simplified. Feel free to comment down below with any other topics that you'd like broken down, and like and subscribe.